Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I'm grateful that you are here to start the session, which is from 2 o'clock to 3:15, and we've passed 2, so let's not delay. The subject is Digital India, how the digital revolution is disrupting your business. It's a time to act and align with the new trend. We have an excellent panel of speakers, and I'd like to invite the chair, Shri Ashutosh Vasant, CMD of RailTel. Sir, would you please join us on the stage? Our panelists, please give him a warm welcome. Our panelists are Sayantan Chatterjee, Associate Director, PwC Private Limited. Welcome and thank you. Mr. Dev Kumar, Chief Technology Officer of Neron Informatics, and I know we're going to get some very interesting information from you. Thank you for being here. Mr. Vipin, and he's an excellent, excellent person to have on a panel because of the wide range and width of knowledge that he has on the subject. And he is actually, in my opinion, the Executive Director of CDOT, not my opinion, he is. But in my opinion, he is actually changing the face of CDOT in a fairly dramatic way. Shikha, Sayal, Director, Sales, Cisco India. Shikha, welcome. Thank you for joining us. And Hemant, Maganlal Joshi, Partner, Deloitte, Haskins and Sales, LLP. Welcome. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not going to take time to introduce the panelists beyond just what I've said, but I do want to hand over the panel to the chair, Mr. Vasant, and ask him to take us through this Digital India program and the revolution that we wish to see. So with those few words, may I please leave the floor to you and let's start the program. Thank you.
Hello, am I audible? Thanks a lot, Mr. Behl. First of all, you got a lovely name. Prem, right? So lovely name. Very good afternoon to you, gentlemen and ladies, and warm welcome after lunch. Though in this Digital India world, I'm the one who couldn't afford lunch today because of breathing minute to minute. But anyways, do you know post lunch we mastered an art which is called as sleeping with eyes wide open. I hope you have all practiced that. It's difficult, but let's try and make things interesting. First of all, I warmly welcome the lady on the dais, Shikha, and my friends on the dais. A warm welcome to each one of you. Let's try and see that we keep the audience alive. Do you know why I was told that this panel is going to talk about what are the outshoots of Digital India, a word so many times spoken, leading to so many conferences and seminars, that I think we need to change that spelling, like what the lady did with my company. She changed the spelling of my company. I liked it. So I think we also need to change Digital India buzzword somehow to keep people excited, right? I don't see much of an audience because probably people are too used to with this word. But anyways, just for the people who are bound now and cannot leave this hall, let me just tell you what has changed, what really has changed with digitization. On a lighter note, it has given birth to number of such seminars and conferences giving employment to so many people. The second is, Digital India buzzword has led to big boom in consultancy services. You know, out of how many of us? 2 are great consultants. Am I right, Mr. Joshi? And Sayantan, big boom to consultancy. Am I right? Every organization is running around to create DPRs. And when you make DPRs, what you need is a big consultant. And the solution implementer, Tyagi sir. Let me share something, a big fact with you. Do you know, I think most of you know it, but in government, when you want your ideas to be put through all hurdles, you hire the best consultant. The consultant stamps it and then it's true. I'm being jovial, but the fact is, yes, they add huge value. What has changed in all these years? See, we have been through an era, particularly I have seen that era when we used to dial up on a dial-up model and were found lucky if you could get attached to an email server. We had celebrated in railways when we changed from 8 kbps to 64 kbps modems. Tyagi sahab, it was an award given to people for changing over. Now if you, in this current generation, you talk about kbps, people say, what are you talking about? Are you sleeping? What has changed now, do you know? Most of the college guys can connect better. 70% of the traffic on WhatsApp now in the last 6 months is video. Do you realize that? Every third post that you get is a high definition or a high loading video. Do you know what is happening? We are all in business. I am a telco, I am a telecom operator. More videos you see. In fact, whenever I speak in forums, I always say, please keep your phones on. If you don't know whom to talk to, dial wrong numbers, but do speak. Papi pet ka sawal hai, kahin na kahin paisa aata hai humko wapas. The fact of life is, let me tell you what RailTel is. RailTel is the backbone provider for every telecom operator in the country. I don't know whether it is news to you. We run fiber along tracks as well as in many cities. And every operator who serves in the country is somewhere or the other on my network. If you see cable TV, every cable TV MSO who is in the country and making money is on my network. Sirs, let me share with you, I run the world's biggest public Wi-Fi network. I don't know whether you agree to it or not. Today we have done 301 full-scale rollouts and 137 rural Wi-Fi stations. The kind of footfalls actually give me, Prem Saab, mind these numbers. With 279 stations, I was doing 8 million unique subscribers per month. If you are traveling twice or thrice on the railway network in a month, I count you only as one. This way, I had 8 million unique subscribers per month on the network, on the Wi-Fi, and 25,000 first-time internet users per day, Joshi ji. First time, we have not seen what internet is, so that is what the railway ecosystem through the Wi-Fi is doing, digitization, doing democratization of access to information and knowledge, and spurring a number of business initiatives across the country. If you now go and see the most remote railway stations, you would find people coming, sitting there with their laptops or devices and actually doing businesses. Whether it is ticket booking, e-commerce, e-education, and we had a phenomenal level of satisfaction. I would like to tell you both, all the panelists here, there is a success story of a coolie in Kerala in one of these stations who gave an interview to one of our agency that he went through Kerala Public Service Commission online education help and he is now a class 2 officer with Kerala Public Service Commission. It is available on the net. We are just going to release the video of the person with all details. Trust me, this is what is the change desired to be done with what all we are doing. It's no use attending conferences, talking about things, unless you bring about a change to the life of the common man. And this is just 301 stations today, but now with the way the government is looking, I see Tyagi sahab looking at watch, but I would remain within my 10 minutes. The government is now, I have a meeting back home, I have to rush again. Now government is saying 400, 300 stations don't mean me anything. You have to do Wi-Fi across 8671 stations, 13,000 trains, all with live Wi-Fi. This doesn't end here. Anything except the washrooms on the stations and the trains have to have CCTV to ensure you have a secured and safe travel across the nation. We are creating, again, Tyagi sahab, business for you, business for many of the panelists here. We are creating continuous LTE corridor under the project called High Speed Mobile Communication Corridor, HSMCC, a word coined by us, by RailTel, which the ministry has accepted. We are creating an LTER corridor across the railway track, first 10,000 around the Golden Quadrilateral, the high speed which carries around 70% of the railway's passenger traffic and goods traffic. and then across the 63,000 kilometers of network. On that, we would run IoT. On that, we would run Wi-Fi. On that, we would run CUG for the operations. And to add to all, we are running, moving to ETCS level 2 of signaling, which is going to change the way the trains run. You would no longer have delays which you have normally with fogs when the driver cannot see the signals, because the signals get repeated inside the trains. This is the world's most modern level of signaling, ETCS level 2, which is on radio blocks. No physical signals, everything repeated in the train, trains control, loco control. You reduce the headway, basically gap between two trains, improve the line capacity. I don't know how many of you know, the train tracks, the driver has no control except speeding and braking. He has no steering. He cannot decide where to stop. He cannot decide whom to overtake. It is all remotely managed. Now we are going on that space. A real digital impact. So just setting the stage of what you can do to create an impact in the life of the individuals. The panelists are very learned people. They have done wonders. We know Dr. Vipin Tyagi. He has been adding every day a new initiative in terms of product support to the nation. But let me begin in a serial order with Joshi ji. Joshi ji, how do you see this impact being carried forward? Because you know the biggest challenge in the country today is, all said and done, huge underemployment and unemployment. If you don't address this, the fruits of this digitization would not reach the masses. What is your take on it?
So, thank you. You know, I'll just come to that in just a few seconds. But I think it's worth sort of reinforcing a few fundamental facts. And being Indians, what we are, you know, very, we underplay our own achievements. The ability or the fact that we have created more than 1 billion digital identities is a world record. Nobody has done this with two biometric, you know, the attributes. The second thing is we have 1 billion mobiles connected. And there are more than 350 million bank accounts connected to all this. This ecosystem has enabled the most illiterate and backward to come into the banking system. And what has happened? He mentioned about, you know, how to impact the lives of the common man or the poor. With that, what is happening is that there were leakages in the system, in direct benefit transfer, you know, the scholarships, the LPG, etc., etc. These are being sort of choked up now. You don't have leakages, and billions of dollars have been saved. So I think we need to keep this in mind. It's a mind-boggling. Now, coming to this, there is an unemployment. It's a fact. And there is going to be a disruption through the emerging technologies of AI, you know, machine learning, IoT, and all this. World over, there is a concern. World Economic Forum has also mentioned that we need to deal with this. And how are we going to deal with this? I think this, so on one hand we have unemployment, other hand you ask for a carpenter, you ask for a teacher, you ask for a healthcare provider, you ask for, you know, the handyman, there are tremendous shortage. So we have a demand, we have a supply, but it's not connected. And you know, the way to do is connect. Like for example, you have the big basket. How it is connected the users with the sellers, and there are teachers getting connected to students, and you know they can operate from anywhere. So with this infra which was mentioned, RailTel is creating the fiber. I think all these villages and towns will get connected, and access to opportunities will happen. So my final comment to have is, I think the issue is not going to be either machines or humans. I think it's going to be how to enhance the power of humans to create opportunities using machines. You know, healthcare, education, how to make teachers smart, how to, you know, get the healthcare professionals smart, how to enable them, you know, and so on and so forth. So I think it's going to be machines and humans working together. Digital revolution is on. Nobody can stop it.
Appreciate that. Really appreciate that. Dave, if I come to you and ask, like you say, you represent Neron. Is it to do with some neural networks or is it to do with something AI? And what are you, in what way, contributing to this agenda?
So
basically, Neron comes in picture after, you can say, as a startup. Okay. So we are a startup company, basically in telecom solution, software or hardware or combination. So last year we started our project with help of some people, and then finally we converted to the Neron Informatics with few of our devices for intercom solution and other stuffs. So basically, before starting up, what we seen in the market, the data speed, this is growing day by day. Mobile speed is growing, broadband speed is growing, and the government initiatives are again spreading through the fiber and other networks. So what we thought, basically, if today we are simply, because we have the data problem, that's why we are calling a normal call, analog voice calls through mobile or telephone or any landline PSTN network. What will be when we get sufficient data in mobile, sufficient data in our laptop in office environment and after office environment in home? So we plan to design an application or a software that comes in a box so that we can manage easily, that is scalable up to 10,000 people, can cater audio, video, also can do some text, can integrate emails, and simplify office environment. So if we say in office environment, there are few things we required. It may be for a startup company, maybe for an enterprise. When a call comes in the company, it announces some IVR. It may be single channel or multi-channel. If we run marketing schemes or we need to connect our team or people, we need a conference bridge. So right now, there are mostly all the manufacturers are based on Meet Me conference, which serve only 30 people conference bridge. So we made it flexible. So 1,000 people can make a single conference bridge. We made IVR system flexible. It can go up to N level. Again, we added some voice broadcast in basic telephony intercom system. And then we made a product that serves this segment. And when we planned this one, we started from 20 users to 20,000 users. So it may be for a small startup, maybe for a mid-sized company, and maybe for an enterprise company. And you mentioned RailTel, so also we are using your network because in Jaipur Northwest headquarters, we enabled all these four subdivisions to make them video calls one desk to another desk. And they are using, I think, almost 200 endpoints as a video calling system.
Wonderful. Wonderful, Dev. Wonderful. In fact, I would like to tell you, see, adoption of technology, there is a huge inhibition on the whole. But the fact is, with the advent of video conferencing, we have been able to save. It looks like a small thing. But you know, in railways, whenever we used to have annual reviews or six-monthly reviews by the minister, each of the zonal railway headquarters, GMs used to come in their saloons. I don't know how many of you know, you have a complete private coach attached at the end with a butler, a server, and you would have 15 people traveling along. So we had the entire paraphernalia traveling every 6 months from the different 16 zonal railways, 9 production units to Delhi. We as RailTel pitched in and said, we are a telecom company. We are providing you high definition telepresence as a service with one of our partners, Cisco, here. We strongly believe as RailTel in collaboration. We do not believe that everything under the sun can be done only by one person. We believe in the power of individual collaborators with vertical domain expertise. We call and invite people. Even if you ask me today, we have two EOIs on RailTelIndia.com where we are inviting all, it's right from startups to big established players who can come and join in the government's mission of digitization. Because I would like to draw your attention, I would not name further, but RailTel is the only backbone network in the country which is secured. Mr. Tyagi knows why. So I would tell him to throw some light on what he is doing. So we all know, but for the benefit of the audience, why don't you, sir, enlighten us with your new initiatives?
Yeah, thank you very much. Your both names are only first name. You know, you don't have a surname. So that, like Ashutosh, Vasant.
Actually, it's my father's name.
Oh, I see.
Because in the fifth board, when I started writing, we as Maharashtrians write our father's name. Okay. So Ashutosh Vasant Sarvate. There was no space. That time the form was small.
All right, so
I adopted this because there was no time to write, again get another form. So I said, in this world now, you should be known by what you do rather than what your parentage is. My dad told me, Ashutosh, time change. You should be known by what you deliver. Doesn't matter what you are, what people should ask you by what you do. I hope I did my father.
Thank you for asking what I do. Okay. I think, you know, C dot is always on the answer side of the equation. We don't have liberty of asking questions, you know. Consequently, today, without any doubt, C dot technologies, we can build large scale international networks of any order. We have, you know, multi terabit capacity, 8 terabit on a single fiber system, DWDM, which is capable of going around the globe and connecting all the countries together. It's already under trial in Chennai. Many of you will know that, you know, BharatNet, the entire technology has come from CDOT, and 100,000 villages are already supplied the technology by 25 manufacturers. We have created capacity of millions of equipments to every month can be produced here. 3,000 crore worth of business happened in last 1 year. ITI is turned around because they are our technology partners. So CDOT is, you know, is a catalyst. It's a R&D organization. And fundamentally, that's what I wanted to talk about, the second thing. So we have, all the technology. But technology is not what is important, you know, going forward. What I realized over a period of time, that we didn't have technology, people were saying, where is the technology? Why do you don't have this terabit router, multi-terabit router? Why everything has to be imported? Now I have it, I ask them, what after this? Okay? That brings to a very interesting thought that one of my salesperson in United States used to ask me. His name was Bob Bolan. He will come and, if you're a stranger, he will come and shake hand with you. He'll say, I am Bob Bolan. And then you will say, what's in it for Bob? First question, so you will say, what? So, what's in it for India? The fundamental question is, are we able to produce technology, core technology from here? It's not a question of capability. It is a question of alignment. It is a question of intent. It is a question of purchase processes. It is a question of people's integrity. It is a question of how we do business here. That is what is the biggest challenge I see. Everybody is doing things right in their own perspective, but the alignment is where the core issue is. Third thing that came to my mind was R.K. Lakshman has actually painted, or you know, famous common man, right? Some of you will know. He didn't have anything that reflects any assets or money, right? Not even a watch in his hand. He used to have a stick because he can't walk properly. The whole issue is that we are trying to solve. Everybody is making money to solve the problem of a common man, of R.K. Lakshman. But where is the business model? So what is happening? Consequently, government is paying, you know, everything. This entire BharatNet has happened because government has put their money into this. And this is the largest investment by the government that has happened anywhere in the world. I was there in MWC and I talked to everybody. We are trying to actually make big difference from the government side. What about the private sector? How much they are sourcing from India? How much R&D is happening? 12% is typical R&D dollars which are required if you want to take the leadership across the globe. Most of the companies. How many percent of the R&D is being invested by Indian companies in India? People say, I have 15,000 engineers, I have 20,000 engineers. They are all working in this city. What are they producing for India? How are they servicing the common man? Is it the job of only government? Is what is important question that we have to move forward from technology all the way to, you know, getting the service. Fourth thing, and I think I my 7 minutes I'm aware, is that we have certain things which are going to strike us. And these things are very, very important things in terms of change of technology. Having broadband, all that infrastructure is fine. People are talking about IoT. Everybody is building their own castle in this IoT world. What is happening is, if I have the application, I put the sensor, I run the business, I monetize it. Where is the public infrastructure? Consequently, CDOT has built a platform called One M2M, compliant platform, 8 standard bodies. That is the only standard compliance platform that is available. We were the first one, and this is the only standard available. 3GPP, ETSI, AREB, TSDSI, like that, there are 8 standard bodies, they have formulated this. Have you heard this before? Why? Because it doesn't suit the people who have their own cozy club that they want to formulate. They don't want a startup to come on board. They don't want a new guy to come and start another application on a public infrastructure. You don't even know 40% of the traffic that is running over the net, nobody knows where it is coming and going. Do you want to have that kind of scenario in IoT, that somebody comes and blasts a bomb and you don't even have a mechanism to trace it? Somebody takes a picture in your house and puts it on the website, you will not be able to trace it. You talked about security. Are we going to move towards that kind of a IoT? Or are we going to have a sensible standard platform put where you are able to find out and you are able to do business in an open fashion? Is the last thing that I wanted to talk about. India is poised to take the leadership, provided we allow Indians to take the leadership. I think biggest impediment that I see in India, everybody is fragmented, and they think that, you know, this is typical in us, I am smarter than you, I have more powerful than you, but collectively, if you put us together, we are nothing. That is what is the stand in the world that we have. So consequently, the last thing that I wanted to talk about, there is a challenge of 5G, there is a challenge of IoT, there is an opportunity, there are technologies which are being built by CDOT and many other R&D institutions, and the people who are heading the companies, multinationals here, have to really think, what are we contributing, how will we take this leadership forward? Thank you.
Thank you, Tyagi. It was very, very enlightening in the sense that it somewhere, jisko kehte na, tar jhinjodna, that is what you have really spoken about. That's phenomenal. In fact, as we know from our college days, CDOT was considered to be a Makkah of the best. That was what the organization began with, as a center of real excellence of the brain power who do something great for the country, and he's doing wonderful. I have something to share with you all, which I principally and very strongly believe in. Anything done for free doesn't come with SLAs. Anything done for free doesn't come with any service levels, any guarantees. So your all business models, whether in government, whether in public or personal, have to have a business model, have to have some benefit accruing out of it to somebody who's willing to pay for that service. Do you know why? I would just tell you a simple example. We build at railway stations phenomenal, beautiful public washrooms. It's not usable after an hour of inauguration. Right or wrong, you would not go. But you would go to a sulabh shauchalay who charges you 2 rupees or 50 paisa because there's somebody who for your payment ensures that it is clean for the next use. Right or wrong? This is what happens with government. I have been speaking in every forum. Don't talk about giving everything free. It should add value to an individual where that person is not feeling fleeced, but he's enjoying in paying you. If you can do this, you have cracked the conundrum of self-sustainability. And this is precisely what we are doing. We run a service called RailWire. You would not see a single board of mine anywhere across the country. I don't advertise. I don't believe in advertising because I believe my brand should promote and get propagated through word of mouth. Go to any college across the country and ask people what is RailWire. The young boys know it. They would call it superlative Wi-Fi experience available at stations because they are able to upgrade their OS. They are able to download the fastest videos. They are able to video chat without buffering. Literally free, sir. First 30 minutes, the world is open to you. If you have an 802.ac device with you, you can download and upload as much as 43 Mbps, which no technology does. No 4G, no 5G. Consistent. Whether you have 5 people on the railway station in Delhi or 5 lakh people as they are in the day, you would get that consistent speed, which I guarantee. That is QoS. There is a business model to that as well. we have a streamline, because if I continue to plow bandwidth like this, I would be dead. And it would be again a slow, bad service, which the, everybody would say, Sarkar karti to hai, chalati nahi hai. We want to break that. We want to ensure whatever we deliver is consistent. You should be proud. What Tyagi Saab said, we in India should create models of excellence which the world should copy. And LTR that is being rolled out is exactly in that path, sir. There is no specification in LTE which supports the R flavor of the railways, which is established in GSMR. But GSMR is a dead technology. So low a spectrum efficiency, so low a throughput that no use. It is actually killing the spectrum available. We told, we are proud, our honorable minister, when I went and shared, we want to roll out LTER. He asked me, is there any rollout anywhere across the world? I said, it's in trial, but we would own the IPR. Why should we follow others? Why should we not set precedents? This is exactly what you're talking about. And he said, yes, we had an industry interaction where a lot of people said, you're talking about signaling, it is safety, it's not telecom. People would die if it goes wrong. What are you doing? There are no standards. Do you know what he said? He asked that person, are you an Indian? Are you not ashamed of raising this question? Why follow somebody else? Why can't we set precedents? That has set the tone now. So we are rolling out LTR, a phenomenally challenging step ahead. But we'll do it. That is what I assure you. So this is what we have to do together. Sayantan, what do you see as a consultant of real action in the ground? Is it really flowing to the lives of individuals or only in conferences?
Well, a very valid question. In fact, I think, as you said, it's like one is obviously digital. Someone said it's like, is it like the old wine in new bottle? Is it the new name for IT, cyber, tech, or is it something else? And I think someone answered, in fact, it's not my connotation. It's not about technology. It's not about any ICT. It's the entire business model which is changing. So what I see outside, and when I say I'm talking in a plural sense for all of us who are consultants or who are advisors, who work with a lot of corporates or I would say startups. And what is changing nowadays, and with the currency, which is new currency, what we call is the data is the new currency. So someone said it's like we're not looking at the rupee or the dollar or the oil or the bullion as the new currency, data is. And again, this is a borrowed quote from one of our esteemed industrialists, he coined that. So what's changing now is that with the huge backbone of data, like where safely as Indians at least we can say that we should not be starved for that, with that in our pockets, as we say, this is what the mobile is. What everyone is thinking is that what is the unique proposition I can create out of it? And when I'm talking about unique proposition, I'm again completely relating to it, that it has to have a business model. Because unless you do something which A, addresses a need, gives a return or a value, and more importantly to its investor, it gives a return, you will not have any, I would say, you can have the CSRs, which is of course different, but every, I would say, business or person that we are interacting is actually harping that what is the return of the value that I'm adding? And at the back end of it is like, I don't need to be following the digitalization mode, because that's something different. There's a difference between digital and digitalization. So when I'm looking at digital, I'm looking at basically enhancing, sometime completely ripping apart, and doing things in terms of be it my supply chain, be it the way I interact with my customers, with my stakeholders, in a fashion which is, I would say it's taking a leap. Like I'm not constrained by whether the location, by the geography, where I'm, and it is being driven by us customers. When I'm saying is like all of us are customers, we are demanding that. So be it healthcare, be it retail, be it consumers, be it any financials. So it's demand, and demand that's pulling, and all the new business models. In fact, we as PwC, we have a huge startup lab that we incubate. And the entire focus is that think of that model. What is that you are going to be addressing? And then you will find the takers for it. So don't be too, I would say, constrained by, okay, what was happening. If you have that spark, and that's what we typically work with. And trust me, with this new age that you're talking about, with the new currency, as I keep calling data as a new currency, it's actually exploding. on ground, and the best thing is that explosion is not centered to only tier one cities, which was the, like, usually it was that because of the way our fundamentally our education system and the, I would say, the infrastructure was. And so now someone with the same phone, and of course any phone, I'm talking about a smartphone for that matter, or your feature phone for that matter, is completely same as someone sitting in, say, a Mumbai versus like any tier three or a village, because he or she is then accessing and providing that unique proposition. And more of that, and what we are seeing is that more of these, the startup communities or the people who are the first level entrepreneurs, they're actually breaking those barriers. Because traditionally they have been impaired. Now they have got something which is the platform. Now what we call the platform, it is unique and is same for everyone. So it is not that because I am of this background or have this, investment and all, I'm advantage. No one is. It's a same level field. And what's happening now is it's a serious challenge to the established business models. So a lot of players, in fact, we say that, I keep again using the word that digital is to the extent that if you don't disrupt yourself, you will be disrupted.
Absolutely.
So if you have this passion that let me cling on to what I've been, so some people say 30 years, if I can use some Hindi, 30 years se ye kar rahe hai, so we know what is to be done best. But sorry, there's a new whiz kid who is basically going to use the same problem and look it in a very disruptive mode and give the best return or the value that you can think of.
Very true, Sayantan. In fact, do you know what has happened primarily with digitization? Getting audience has become simple. So your life cycle of an idea being generated and either clicking big or you looking for the next option has become very fast. What I want to say in a more, this was more polished, rather the life cycle of germination to death or hitting it big has become very fast, one. Second, even the brick and mortar stores, did we have ads of cement 20 years back? No, but today every third ad is of cement, TMT, Saria, things which never required. Now, but even for them, because they see, if they fail to do this, there is some store somewhere, some factory which is serving the local market. So you have to create brands. Digitization is basically ripping apart the gap between access to your audience, the connect of your idea to the masses, and the ability to really think fast and kick it big. I was with the Special Secretary DOT in Northeast just on the, we in fact invested, I would not say sacrificed, we invested our holy holidays to be in Northeast because we thought, let's quickly do that Act East and Look East policy of Government of India. So for you it may be news, but Tyagi sahab knows it. We are the first to lay fiber in the country as railways. News for many of you, ahead of DOT. Churchgate Virar 1985 fiber is the first fiber in the country, sir. So we realized it the hard way that what it takes to really run railways effective communication to be 24/7 on, because in railways, trains, unless they are known, they don't get driven. So a single minute blip in communication, a simple hello to every station master, 7,000 stations, is booked as a punctuality loss in my account, and the morning I have to explain. For outsiders, till we joined Railway Shikha, we thought trains run like this only. 10-12-15 minute idhar udhar chalta, koi fark nahi padta. After joining railway services, we realized 2 minute ka bhi idhar udhar hota hai, to itne joote padte hain subah. That is what keeps the wheel running. When we join the railways, the first thing, first day we are told is, wheel never stops. You are dead or alive, we don't bother. This is how ruthless railways is. But that is what is the connect which drives. So Northeast coming back, now we are trying to rip apart the business model of one of our co-brothers who claims to have superior SLAs, because now I am laying OPGW across all state electricity boards. So I would make them run for their money. Northeast, I would be the best player. And there I was astonished when I was roaming around the streets of Aizawl and I switched on the TV, the first four channels are Korean. How, anybody from Northeast here? First four channels are Korean translated into Mizo in Aizawl. I said, why this? They said, there is no other content. So we are not connected. So we thought, we immediately realized this is the time to bridge the gap. Cultural gap creates the biggest distance in humans. This is what is the need of the day. Shikha, you have been with us. We are big time partners as our parent organizations. How do you see the growth ahead? I see huge business, but digitization is your core. So there would be not, it would be wrong to ask you, is it disrupting your business? Yes, in a positive way, you are making more money, right? Then what you made all these years, how do you see the challenge from Tyagi Saab's local initiatives? He looks forward to probably take over Cisco anytime soon. Like I told my big partner Google, be prepared, I would take you over.
Well, I think yes, it is disrupting us, and it's disrupting us in a positive manner, the way it is an opportunity for everyone around. So yes, it is an opportunity, and all around, even I am just like 2.5 years with Cisco, but you'll see it in print all over. But I think that's not just what digitization efforts of the organization are all about. If you look at the 2015 directive of Digitize India by our Prime Minister, there was a very clear mandate that came in from Cisco Global, and India is one of the front runners on the digitization initiative globally for Cisco. And you know, our global CEO, he visits India, and our chairman separately, they visit India 2 times a year to really follow this through. And there's an immense amount of investment that's coming in. If you were to look at initiatives, smart cities, of course, is one of them where, you know, there's close work that's happening with the government. I think one of the key contributions that, you know, we all as an organization undertook is educate our governments that Digitize India is not about creating Wi-Fi hotspots. I think that's a very big positive shift that has happened for the country. Wi-Fi is just a means of connectivity. It's an enabler, yes. And I think what you do with that connectivity is what is of utmost importance. And I think that's where our consulting friends really play a very critical role. How do you really take the services to the citizens? How are they consuming it? What is it that is really making their lives simpler? So it's not just about creating Wi-Fi hotspots and, you know, that's a smart city. It's not that. Are you able to use it for activities like surveillance? Are you able to use it for, you know, lighting up your streets in the evening? Are you able to use it to collect data at a central point which you could use for other services? You know, automated parking lots, does that generate revenue for your civic bodies? So this is, I think, a lot of work has gone in from our end to really lift the initiative from just Wi-Fi. And to your point, if you look at it, the way we look at it as an opportunity, if we were to follow global standards in India, we need 8 million Wi-Fi hotspots actually to have a global standard access to every Indian. And this is, you know, of course, there is a 4G or a 5G that will come in the future. But if you were to really look at an opportunity for us to grow, that is where it is. And of course, I'm Indian, so I'll not answer that CDOT and Cisco. I'll leave it.
I was just joking. But on the whole, yeah, definitely, sir. But on the whole, I can see a very positive shift in the country. Do you know some of the physical things I would say? Earlier, you ought to know somebody to get your driving license. Earlier, you ought to know somebody to get your passport. You had to compulsorily go through an agent for all these activities, including your identity card. These are all stories of the past. Yesterday, I was astonished and happy to see the cook at my place ordering a bicycle on Snapdeal for his child. I was so astonished. Security called up and said, there is a delivery for you. I said, I didn't order anything. No, he said, there is some package for you and a big one. Then I asked, did anybody order? They said, no. Then I asked the cook, he said, no, I ordered a bicycle for my child and I got a great deal. So that is what is empowerment. This is just small part of it, but imagine on EPDS, if a person who was till yesterday not aware what his eligibility was, or till yesterday a wheat farmer in Sihor never knew that there was something called crop loss payment by the government, trust me, it is so difficult to even get your what you call Sadbara revalidated. You are made to run from pillar to post in every revenue outstore. But now, on the map, digitized map, you go to the site of the government, you can find out whose name appears there. Sir, that is what is empowerment of the masses. Democratization of information is what is going to uplift each individual and feel counted. See, if you ought to know somebody to get your work done, you are not counted. There is somebody else more privileged than you. In my position, I can go to an RTO and tell him, I'm not going to stand in line, somebody else does it for me. But is it democratization? No. Everybody should be able to go to his time slot, get his dues or her dues, what is available. And that is what is bringing that enabler is connectivity. Why we are saying, see, when the big modern countries, then they claim we have 100% hotspot or 100% Wi-Fi. What's so great about it? Their entire size is less than that of Kerala. We are talking about a country which is so huge. So here, when we have taken this mission of having every station across entire Indian Railway network to have high-speed Wi-Fi Shikha, do you know what it creates? It creates access to information and knowledge to 70% of country's population. Mark my word, 70% of country's population, because railways being the most affordable and most secure means of travel in the country, all population clusters actually develop along the railway lines. So that is how is the connect of the railways. And government rightly did this after so many years. Every district headquarter, capital to start with in Northeast, is now being connected by railways. You have huge NHI DCL link, 6-lane highways, entire Northeast. Power lines are already there. You are really creating that connect, which is essential, absolutely essential. Yeah, Joshi ji, you wanted to say something.
Yeah, and so just, yeah. I couldn't resist a couple of things. One is a classic story of India Post. India Post, as you know, has 100,000 post offices. And with the, you know, the SMSs and the emails and the WhatsApp, that people don't write letters, and then money order business is
wiped out with the ballots.
And you have online transfers through UPI and Beam and whatnot. So they sat back and thought, how do we stay relevant? And they said, we have this huge outreach. Can we convert ourselves into a digital bank? And that's exactly what is happening. So that the postman will be taught and empowered to carry a handheld device and take the banking and the products last mile, literally, the households. So this is a very big paradigm shift, and we're very happy to help the government.
That's phenomenal. Sir, I would only say to the audience that if you do whatever you do to the best, your job is secured. Whatever you are doing, if you are even sweeping, wiping or cleaning, if you do your best, you cannot be challenged. So I tell all my people in my organization, come what may, in spite of the bloodbath in the market, we are still revenue positive. We are the only telecom company in the country and the government of India consistently profitable, consistently paying dividend, consistently being given stretch targets. Nobody at RailTel works as an employee. Everybody is a co-owner. Anybody who says he's not a co-owner is not inside RailTel. This is what we drive RailTel as. It is a 100% Sarkari company, but it is started as a startup. So you can imagine the kind of satisfaction when we got that within staying in the government systems, we created a startup, a thriving public sector, only consistently positive company, and being challenged every day with higher service levels. Ping me if you find my services not good. We see every problem as an opportunity to serve you better. That's what it is. Tyagi sir, I would request you and any one of the panelists to, if they want to add something, otherwise we leave the floor open for any questions.
Two things I wanted to talk about. Picking up from whatever Shantan has said. In fact, in India, the currency is new data. Data is, new currency is one way looking at it, because we are all, first of all, I think currency. So we don't have, the data is new currency. Because all money transfer, everything is mostly happening on, apart from some cash transactions which are, necessarily to be done in spite of demonetization. There is no technological or business model challenge. Consequently, that is fueling now quite a lot of new innovation which is coming along. Second thing is that voice is commodity. So if your business model is based on voice, because voice is 64K streaming, I mean, this is very, very small part of the new data. So data subsumes voice. So you can't have your, and data itself is not monetizable. Why? Because, you know, you get 1 GB per day. I mean, see, you will not remember. What you will remember, you watched video for so many hours. So consequently, the important thing that is required by startups and innovators and everybody is, how do we generate the services using the platform which is being built right now? It's a matter of few years that we will have the connectivity to almost everybody, the way it is going along. Then what? How do we actually create services to change and generate money? You know, can we make the total cost of travel for a villager lower? Can we make the total cost of, you know, somebody getting a doctor's attention lower? Can we subsidize the education to an extent by using digital means? Those are the challenges to me. The technology happened to be necessary, but the important thing is, I don't see anybody actually, people talking about all of those use cases of connected cars. I mean, how many drivers will go without any employment here? First of all, it is very difficult to implement in India, knowing technology reasonably well. But those are the use cases which are being talked about. IoT, I mean, what does it mean for people? Putting a chip inside you might make you healthy, all right. So those who can afford that kind of attention of immediate medication might be okay. That's why the point that I want to make in a very subtle fashion is, address the real problems.
Very, very, very vital thing again. And I would again like to quote a real life example which has brought the changes in the life of the people. Some of the panelists would know. We rolled out in Sabarkantha, the remotest district of Gujarat, where people have to actually walk to access even ration, 10, 15, 12 kilometers, Sabarkantha, the remotest, the northmost district. We rolled out in 55 GPs in 30 days Wi-Fi. People called us mad. The local DDO, a very forward-looking guy whom I met up in a startup hackathon in IIM Ahmedabad. I said, we are doing this. He said, join me. I would be a collaborator. So the Sabarkantha local, what do you call it as, farmers societies became my partners. The Jila Panchayat became my partner. The Gram Panchayat became my partners. And we rolled out on RailWire model, Wi-Fi in all the 55 Gram Panchayats. Even the secretary IT came to me and told me, what are you doing? Why are you wasting time, energy and money in creating Wi-Fi? What would happen to those people? I said, only wait for the next 15 days. Do you know what we did? We said, all payments for all village development works, whether they are making new roads, making new schools, digging new wells, any initiative which is being paid under rural development program, no money would be paid unless the Talati goes and clicks a photograph from any of the mobiles that he has and just come to the Wi-Fi hotspot. Do you know what we did? We had a back-end application running. Every time he went, he or she went, he or she was tagged by his lat-long date, time and ID. Now, if I am the Talati and I'm going and supervising a check dam work, Shikha, no payments are made till all my photographs sync and show that it is actually made. We got felicitated in public by the Jila Panchayat. They said this is the first time that what the money is being spent for us is actually producing results, because it was on a public URL. It's not on a government website. Even from here, I can give you an access and you can see in Sabarkantha what all development works are going on. It brought in visibility and a cross-check, a public accountability to your spending. If you can do this in India, sirs, you would have a different country. That is what, Shikha, you have to do. It is not just Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is just an enabler. You are creating a means of bringing what is called as transparency, accountability and ownership and governance. This is what is the need of the country, sir. Do this and you change this country. We need not go west. Last time I was speaking in one of the forums, I said the next MWC should be India, because India is the biggest market. Why do you have to go to Spain or why do you have to go to Shanghai to attend an MWC Mobile World Congress? We are the biggest consumers.
country is already driving. The biggest MNCs of the world are coming here not for sir charity. Money makes the mayor go. Fact of life. Let's realize this. We are the biggest population, consuming population. We are the biggest market. We just have to bring transparency, accountability, and ownership and governance. We are a different country, and that is what we are aimed at. We will do it together. Now I leave the floor open for questions, unless Sayantan or Shikha or Dev or
You know, I think there is another very interesting story happening on India Stack. I don't know how many people have heard of India Stack. The India Stack story is through paperless, presentless, cashless, and a consent layer. What you would do, what you can do virtually, is amazing. You take, for example, when you buy a property and you have to register a property, you know, previously you had to go to that office, it stinks, and you have to wait, and somebody will ask for money, and, you know, all sorts of things. Today, sitting in your office, you could register this document through this, so there is a cashless, paperless, presenceless. The paperless will come from digital locker, which the government is implementing, all your certificates, documents. Now you can imagine the multiplier effect of all this. What's going to do to the whole ecosystem in terms of transparency, accountability, trail, and so on and so forth. So there are a lot of business opportunities in developing and working through the India Stack. This is just
true. In fact, these are what my request is. We have these isolated cases of excellence. Okay. We have to actually now go on replication what is of the best. As Tyagi Sahib is saying, the concept of one-upmanship of trying to say what I did is best has to go away. There has to be a repository or a parallel independent evaluation of what is best for the country, and it should be then driven with a missionary zeal, with no obstacles, no any kind of flips permitted. Steamroll. This is what is chosen after a lot of debate. This is what is going to create a difference in the lives of the Indians or the common citizens. No opposition tolerated. Go ahead and deliver. That is what has to be done, because the country is too big. We have to have this quickly to really empower every last man standing. Otherwise, this would remain as isolated stories. Not good for the country. We have to do this. And I think this should soon happen. The way things are being pushed, I personally see the kind of targets being pushed to us. They are maddening. Actually maddening, sir. Working in a PSU which is delivering and being at the top actually is a miserable thing in the current scenario with the kind of targets being plowed on. Terrible targets. बहुत ज़्यादा काम करती नहीं somehow मैं आपको एक चीज़ बताऊँगा सरकार में अगर आप काम करते हो पहले से तो आप हमेशा ज़िंदगी भर काम करोगे because you are branded as somebody who delivers and somebody who delivers is always counted as the one who would solve problems so you never have respite आपको कभी breathing time नहीं मिलेगा आपकी इमेज कैसे बनाई आपने कैसे ब्रांड बिल्ड की उसके ऊपर है आप अगर शुरू से कूल रहोगे कूल तो जिंदगी भर कूल रहोगे बट यदि आपने जन्म से काम किया है तो यू आर ऑलवेज कंसिडर्ड एज समबडी हु हैज टू डिलीवर मोर देन व्हाट यू आर डिलीवर्ड ऑल दिस टाइम इट्स फन इट्स अ डिफरेंट किक इट्स अ डिफरेंट एंजॉयमेंट आई वुड नाउ लीव द फ्लोर ओपन टू ऑल ऑफ यू हूएवर इज स्टिल practicing sleeping with eyes wide open but still connected.
Anyone wanting to ask anything?
Yeah, gentlemen. Can somebody help him with the mic?
Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Very good afternoon. Yeah.
Myself Kapil Parashar from Vyom Digital Services. It's very mind-blowing experience from your speech. And we are working for smart living with digital everywhere. It's my vision. And we have started my startup. Then I came to know that nobody do it alone in IoT and M2M. So we have gathered so many startups with us. And now Vyom is an umbrella. And there are so many startups like manufacturing, big data analytics, and servicing. And C-Dot, and Mr. Tyagi is sitting here. He has given a very good directions for me and my startups for that. And he's doing very well. I think Startup India is very good platform for like us who are very young and we are doing for country. So we are looking a new opportunity with RailTel when after hearing with you, if you need, we will go together.
I appreciate that. In fact, as I said in the beginning, even as we speak, there is an UI open on my website, which is inviting partners in digital services platform, another BA and SIs for my big projects, because we as RailTel are almost serving every unconnected location. I had yesterday, I don't know if you, it is again a news to you, the GST rollout by the government, all the officers, all the commissionerates were on railways telepresence, of course with partnership with my partner, but it is a managed service. It is only RailTel which in government organization serves you on pay per use per month model. You don't buy anything, because we realized if you buy anything, that is an obsolescence challenge, one. Second challenge is in government, I cannot buy what I want to, I have to give the generic specs to give equal opportunity to all. Okay. So I intend buying the best but end up with the worst, because the specifications can be matched and it is taxpayers' money, it is not my money. What is government? Okay. You see a lot of college students, first opportunity going, why don't you take your seat, sir? The first opportunity, they would go and burn buses. Those idiots don't realize it is their father's tax money. There is no government. What is government? Read a book called Sapiens. It tells you humans' biggest innovation has been creating a, what do you call, illusion accepted by masses of companies, corporations, money, legal rules. These are all myths. They are nothing but, except for jhaad, paudhe, pani, parvat, hawa, ye reality hai. Baki paisa is absolute myth. 8 November ke baad kal tak jo aap chupa ke rakhte the, uske koi value nahi bachi. Kisi ki jeb mein reh gaya to wo gaali de raha hai ki mujhe opportunity mili change karne ka. Am I right?
Yes,
it is myth, okay. Biggest myth. What is government? What is a corporation? They are means to create myths by so-called sorcerers. Lawyers are sorcerers. Sorcerers, samajhte hai aap? Jadu tona karne wale. Jo pehle village mein jadu karta tha ki main aisa kuch karunga, uske baad mein theek ho jayega. Aur everybody believed, jo kuch log theek ho gaya bolte, iske mantra mein jadu hai. Lawyers are nothing else but wahi jadu karte hain. Wo jab dhang se wo jaduhi cheeze likhte hain, to ek corporation ban jati hai. Usse fayda kya hota hai? Kal aapne mere se service li, to I am not suable. It is the corporation. Okay. I am out, the corporation still survives.
Yeah, yeah.
You are right?
Yeah.
These are all myths. So reality is something different. So coming back, by more myths being created, you have more businesses being generated. It's as simple as that. So you are welcome. Join us as partners.
Okay.
In fact, I had the DG of CBEC with me yesterday and he said, Ashutosh, we have still so many places unconnected.
Okay.
We are suffering on connectivity. So as I said, Joshi ji, if you are doing your job well, whatever it is, any job, if you are the best, nobody can beat you.
Okay.
Do that well. That is what all I would say. Yeah, any other questions? We welcome partners, we welcome ideas, we welcome people who have the fire in their belly to do something great. Come on, we would be giving you the platforms for that. Crowd happy? No questions? That's the best teacher can have. Do you know what has happened? I would request each one of you to go back and educate your young peers, your young children at home. What is being lost in the country today, which hurts me, is respect for somebody whom you can look up to as an ideal. If you go and ask your child, he or she no longer has the teacher as an ideal. Unfortunately, the wrong part of digitization and access to information is the child always feels, I know more than the teacher. We, when we grew up, we had somebody to look up to, somebody to follow, somebody to imbibe from. No longer. The young crowd says, I know more than that, because I Google and find 10 other answers to what the teacher can teach. So we are trying to empower the teacher back by having 2D, 3D content in all languages from class 1 to 12th, all boards available, so the teacher knows more than the child. You are getting me? We have to bring ideals in life. There has to be somebody to look up to, either the parents or the teacher or somebody who you look up to and say, I want to become like this. Because unless you have ideals in life, you are a destroyed society, a destroyed culture. You agree with me, Sayantan? Essential. And this is what is destroyed gradually and successively with the implementation of policies. And this is what destroys a nation. You have to have some ideals in life. You have to have some leader to look up to. Create that. if you don't have an ideal for your children, be an ideal. Be the one who people look up to. I want to follow this. This cannot be by danda. This has to be by excellence. You have to be excellent in what you do. I think kafi gyan ho gaya. Anybody else wants to add something or we should sign off? Yeah, sir. Tell me. A mic to him, please.
Thank you.
Yeah, we're just ending. We're just in time. 3:30. Yes, sir.
It's a question, maybe perhaps not directly addressed, but it's open to the panel. I'm from Ranjit from RailTel Semiconductors. We work with Tyagi, your organization. What I see, I knew something about RailTel, but learned a lot more today. I believe that both of your organizations are the unsung heroes, just like Indian military. Perhaps it's a little exaggeration, but in my heart, I don't think so. They truly are. The question is, you've been doing a lot. In certain areas where government needs certain markdarshan, maybe they're going to bring out some legislations where they need good advice. Do you do that? Do you advise government?
I would tell you it is difficult, but yes, if you can sync in a way that makes sense to them. Their bigger objectives and the core of good for the country. If the two you stitch together, a difficult job, but yes, it is agreed to. As I said, LTER is the biggest example. No standards. When you release 15 in LTE or FRMCS, it is gradually moving to what we aim for doing, leapfrogging. And what we told them is, across the world, the final software gets developed somewhere in Bangalore, Hyderabad or Pune. Why give it to somebody else who develops it, co-brands it and gives it back to you? Let's do it here.
Yes, absolutely. I want to touch two points. Somebody, we mentioned data is new currency, it's the new oil and all that. But where is the ethical angle to all that? Yeah. Does government want to address that point? Yeah. Is my data open to everyone? Is it game for everyone?
I would take this and then let others also tell you. Do you know we are the biggest data owners, not just because of the Wi-Fi, but even through the reservation system? You never ask before filling forms, do you? Anybody who has to travel in railways, whatever we ask, even if we ask how many hair on your head, you would also count and write that. Necessity. But that data is secured, absolutely secured in my data centers, not being accessed to anybody, including my Wi-Fi data. Though I know each one of you, what you are doing, what are your interests, what is your money capacity, your buying capacity, what is your propensity to have the next buy, because I have the big brother as my back end. But we still have very clearly legislated these things are a priority, security of the data, no data breach. So you can draw inferences on the best of the trends of the various curves, but you can't get into details of individuals. Yes. Not allowed.
Let me augment your question. I think you asked whether government we are able to advise and all that. I mean, CDOT's role is actually we are the backroom boy of the technology boys of the Department of Telecommunication. Consequently, we are called upon most of the time. What will happen in 5G? We are part of the 5G forum. We are part of some of the initiatives which are there. But government is actually independent body and they listen to everybody. So we definitely contribute. Like the architecture of the BharatNet was designed by CDOT. And then we put it forward. Like that, we continue to do that. But the second question that you have asked is actually a real question going forward. We are designing AI engines. And I was looking at the architecture of AI, how it is coming along as of now. I said that there has to be a regulatory aspect going forward in few years, which says that every AI will be driven by ethics engine. And that ethics engine will have the rules that you don't destroy family structure. You do not do things which are against the law in that particular jurisdiction. These are few examples. So we need to have ethics built in. Otherwise, this machine to machine and artificial intelligence will lead to the unintended consequences, and we will have to then do the repair of that. So the question is absolutely relevant, and the IEEE is also working on ethics. Also, there are committees which are getting formulated globally on ethical part of the whole technology progression. So really, right question.
I would here commit one thing that yes, you have to try your best, but sometimes challenges are there. Like We as railways, as I told you, we are the first to lay fiber in the country. And we have learned it that if you really want to monetize your asset, it has to be an armored fiber. BharatNet somehow is not doing it, sir, in spite of repeated pleas at all levels. Every operator in the country lays armored. When I began operations in 2002 and I used to speak in forums, people used to say, Sarkari company ho, aapke paas paiso ki kya kami hai? Then I used to answer, I have my own P&L. I have borrowed money from State Bank of India to create this organization. I have no support from railways. Let me clarify to all of you, my entire business, only 9% is from railways because they are my parent, I have to serve them. Rest all is hard fought in the red ocean market. Every telco is my customer. There we lay armored fiber because you can trace your fiber. Unfortunately, the big brother doesn't lay armored fiber. It is not traceable. You are not able to monetize. This is going to be a challenge for the country. This is a challenge. I still plead, still pray. Next generation realizes because every commercial operator lays armored fiber in the country, sir. Every commercial operator for the strong reason what railways learned way back in 85. Anyways, yeah.
I think it's very interesting you mentioned about security, data privacy. But none of us hesitate to use Google.
Yeah.
And there we don't even ask any question, don't raise any doubt, and Uncle Google is happily collecting data, and God knows all the algorithms are running, and you surf once for a washing machine, and next time you put it on, you'll get 10 pop-ups of washing machine. So I think we need to really get back to the fundamental issue.
Joshi ji, what I said was you have to create self-sustainable businesses. Tell me, why would Google create a search engine and map every street for you to drive to this place? What for? What pays that? They have to have sustainable models. So as long as they are not...
Plus the thing is that we've had this debate about security versus, like, in fact, especially like some sectors are quite prone to it. But it's that balance, and especially where India is right now, I would say, do we, I would say, compromise growth for security?
No, it's
a fine balance, exactly.
No.
Or do we say that, okay, like, do we want to have people who like to prosper and let them make some mistakes? Because it's as we say, if we want to be too safe, we'll not have any new innovation. We'll basically tread the same path. So the when the credit cards, debit cards, you keep on hearing some of these frauds. And mind you, they will, because no system has been created outside human world. They have been created by humans. So you will always have a humanable hack for it.
Yes.
You will always have a leak for it. But the position that we are in India, it should not be the impediment for us to say, hey, it's something which is not safe, let's not. It's a drag back. So the way we are saying is it will be there. It's something we are, as consultants, we work a lot. We have a huge cybersecurity practice. We work with it. But nothing is ever foolproof.
Absolutely.
That's the way.
I think I would thank the panelists for sparing their valuable time and interacting with everybody out here and sharing their views. Thank you very much. I think we are just absolutely in time to close this. I thank you all and thank the audience for remaining awake. Thank you very much.
Thank you, speakers, for the enlightening session. May I please request Mr. Ashutosh Vasant to hand over the token of appreciation to all our speakers. Mr. Vipin Tyagi. Mr. Dev Kumar. Mr. Hemant Joshi. Mr. Sayantan Chatterjee. Ms. Shikha Sayal.
Empowered ladies last
time. So we are always ones to be honored.
The lady
always has the last one. Yes. May I also request Mr. Sandeep Sandialia to please hand over the token of appreciation to Mr. Ashutosh. I would also like to thank our audience for patiently listening, and I hope you've gathered good information.